Welcome back. We are still joined with Dr. Yvonne Young and Dr. Viviana Coles, along with Narvin and Althea Logans. Let's talk about relationship expectations.
Absolutely. Starting with the dating phase, because we've all heard these stories, or maybe we've experienced it, where one person is really into the other person not so much. Or maybe someone's looking for a hookup, and the other person's looking for a long-term relationship. So, oh my goodness. We got a lot to get through. in the next 6 minutes.
Well, I was an expert for the Great Love Debate Tour last year, and what I kept seeing over and over was people had all these cheesy lines and strategies to try to get a date. When the truth is, you need to ask yourself, why am I going out with you? Why do I even want to go on a date? Because having clarity and your intent is probably one of the most critical factors in having a good time dating, because the purpose of dating is threefold: to have fun, to learn about yourself through other people, and through that engagement to really confirm your needs versus your wants. And as you go after that, make sure that you are politically incorrect and let someone see you for who you truly are, not what you're pretending to be.
Yeah. Okay.
And trying to be ready to go on a date is another thing too. Mentally being able to say, okay, I have worked through such and such issues that I've been dealing with from maybe a previous relationship. Let's get ready for what I'm going to put out there into the world. Because oftentimes, especially with dating, what you put out there is what you're going to attract.
Okay, but wait a minute.
But
what about these people? Like, open, honest communication. I'm a super fan of all of that.
Yeah.
But what about these folks who, on a first date, they sort of like lay out their resume?
They have the
like
25 point
kids?
Checklist.
Where do you see yourself in 5 years? You know, some people, by being open and honest, can be a little too open and honest.
Well,
I'm
sorry.
That's
Here's what goes wrong with that. What someone is doing at this point is wanting to turn a date into a drive-through window like you would go to at McDonald's.
That's a great analogy.
You cannot drive through somebody's mind ear to ear and then come out with the end results you're looking for. The better thing for you to do, and I caution people when they go on these dating sites, you go and put out basically a laundry list of, I'm not going to put up with this. I'm only looking for a husband. This is all I want. And the truth is, why don't you just start with, hi, I am. How's your day? Tell me about you, because when people speak, there's a saying, out of the abundance of the heart, that mouth will speak. Let people talk, because people will tell you who they are as well as who they are not within the first 10 minutes of you meeting them.
But shouldn't you have some non-negotiables? For example, mine would be, I don't want to date a smoker.
Mm-hmm. I think that it is important to put those sort of things out there, game changers, deal breakers. But I think you'll find that most of these things, when you fall in love with somebody, they're not deal breakers. Some might be like, I'm not willing to leave this state, or I'm not willing to move out of the city for a job. I'm not willing to have kids, or I really must have kids, or you must love dogs. Things like that that are staples, that are fixed points in your life, you do want to share. But whether or not you like action movies, whether or not you go to sleep before 8 p.m., those aren't things that, if you're in love, you're not willing to negotiate.
Oh, yeah. For me, that's a total red flag. If you like action movies, it is not going to work. Totally kidding. So at what point, though, I guess moving into the commitment phase, once you've been on a few dates and once you've really had the opportunity to get to know one another, at what point are you looking for these so-called red flags?
Well, let's go, and I think you said this thing. When we get to this commitment phase, we need to define, what is it I'm being committed to?
DTR, determine the relationship.
That's it, because there's this tendency that all people have to operate in this vague gray area of assumption. And you know what happens when you divide assumption up, ask you me. So you don't want to assume anything. That is the time when you say, well, you know, what are your views on money? Are you a saver or a spender? Well, when will you spend and when do you save? What is your view on family? Do you like everybody being able to drop by, or does that drive you nuts if my mother or my brother, my cousin comes by frequently? I mean, you have to look at the things that are indigenous to your lifestyle. And just like what was said earlier, If it's not something that's organic to you, or it's not something that's part of what you consider to be reasonable, do not compromise yourself, because it will only come back to bite you.
Yeah.
And this is the time in the relationship that you can diminish the ability and the opportunity for insecurities to be created. And one of the things that you can do to diminish that is to make sure that you are asking, hey, what are we doing here? How are you feeling? Are you dating other people? Are you sleeping with other people or not? Are we expecting to go visit for the holidays together? What's going on? You want to kind of have those questions laid out on a very surface level of commitment, so that you can really dive in and not feel so insecure and like you're holding back emotionally.
So when you guys go back to the dating phase, how far down the road in the dating phase did you guys start having these serious conversations about, are we spending holidays together? You know, what do you think about long-term money strategy? How far down the road were you?
Say, about 6 months?
About 6 months.
Yeah. About 6 or 7 months.
Mm-hmm. And now that you've been married for 5 years, has there ever been a time, and forgive me for asking personal questions, but I assume you're okay with this since you're on live television right now.
Right.
Seeking professional help, has that been part of the conversation?
Well, we started going down a road, and it was a very bumpy road, and I live by something. I like to say divorce is not an option. That's just me. And talking to her about that, we need help. You know, yeah. Even if it's not as bad as the next person, I love you. So let's seek help. And Divine Interventions led us to Dr. Yvonne Young, and he has been a fantastic help.
Well, listen,
I've said
guys,
kudos to y'all for getting to that point and realizing, hey, need some help before it got really bad. Now, you can connect with both of our experts online. You can connect with Dr. Young and also with Dr. Coles. We'll put all the information up. It's Dr. D. I'm going to mess it up again.
D. Yvonne Young.
And TexasRelationshipTherapy.com.